Hi, and welcome to this tutorial on the Flux Immersive channel. Today we're going to look at how to use Ableton Live and Spat Revolution within the setting of an immersive mix using the local audio path mode. Spat Revolution is a suite composed of one standalone software and three plugins, Spat Send, Spat Return, and Spat Room. The local audio path mode is the easiest way to connect Spat and Ableton when they're both on the same device. This mode enables the exchange of audio and automation information between the two programs. In this example, we're going to use an electronic music session that we want to mix in different formats: binaural, quadraphonic, and 7.1.4. First and foremost, we must be sure that there are no audio drivers selected in Spat Revolution, and that the sample rate and block size correspond to those found in Ableton. Now, let's prepare our Ableton Live session. We're going to use the audio tracks to send audio towards Spat Revolution and the return tracks to receive audio. The advantage of this method in Ableton Live is that the audio tracks are automatically connected to the return tracks. This is a prerequisite in order to ensure that Spat Revolution functions correctly with any DAW. All the tracks that send audio to Spat must be connected to all the return tracks. So let's create the necessary return tracks. Seeing as Ableton Live only supports stereo tracks, we'll create 9 and open a Spat Return plugin on each. Our session contains only mono or stereo sources. If our source had a greater number of channels, we'd have had to deconstruct the original audio files in order to create the necessary amount of stereo files. We'll now insert a send plugin on each of the audio tracks. In order to enable the local audio path mode on the plugins, we hold the Control key and click the Enable button. We'll carry out this action on both the sends and the returns. We can see in Spat that our different virtual ins and outs are now exposed. Here, our inputs are all stereo, yet some of them are actually mono. The simplest way, when Spat is interfaced with Ableton Live, is to use the input transcoders in order to employ only one of the two available channels. Once that's done, we can create our three rooms, one binaural, one quadraphonic, and one 7.1.4. To finish our routing in Spat, we'll route the binaural room directly to an output, and for the other rooms, we'll use the transcoders to correctly assign the different channels of each room towards a stereo output. Returning to Ableton, we can see that the audio is being sent to SPAT and that the audio from SPAT is coming back into Ableton. For the binaural room, for the quadraphonic room, and for the 7.1.4 room. You'll notice, however, that we sometimes lose synchronization between Ableton and SPAT Revolution. This is because Ableton disables silent audio tracks. If after a few seconds no audio begins to play on a track containing a SPAT send or return, the track will be disabled and the synchronization between Ableton and SPAT Revolution lost. To avoid this problem, we provide a tool that allows a track to remain enabled under all circumstances, called Max for Live. To find it, connect to the Flux Immersive website at flux.audio. Once on the site, go to the Resources tab, then to the Knowledge Base category. Then click on SPAT Revolution, and at the bottom of the page, you'll find resources on DAW integration templates. When scrolling through this page, you'll find the section concerning Ableton Live. The file we want is called Ableton Live Sync Box, so click on Download. This resources page also contains templates that facilitate working between Ableton Live and SPAT Revolution. You'll also find a link to documents regarding the integration of Ableton Live with SPAT Revolution. Once our Max for Live sync box patch is downloaded, we can install it in Ableton Live. In order to do that, we'll find the Ableton User Preferences under Options, Preferences, and then the Library tab. My user preferences can be found under F Documents Ableton User Library. So let's go to the User Library folder, then into Max for Live. As you can see, I've already installed my sync box here. You can drag and drop your file into this folder. Afterwards, we must restart Ableton to ensure that it detects the sync box. Finally, to use it in Ableton Live, go to the User Library in the Max for Live tab, and there you'll find the sync box. Now insert it before all the send plugins and all the return plugins that use the local audio path mode. We can now check that the synchronization between Ableton Live and SPAT Revolution is stable. Thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up and a share. As always, if you've not already done so, subscribe and activate the bell so as not to miss any future content on this channel. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below, and as for me, I'll see you soon in a future video.